So I hope it's clear that the aggregation framework is designed to allow you to create a data processing pipeline, as we've seen several times. Now, you can include as many stages as you need in order to achieve a goal. For each stage, you just need to consider what input that stage needs to receive and what output it needs to produce. Now, what I want to talk about here is the fact that many tasks require us to use more than one stage with the same operator. For example, we frequently need multiple group stages in order to achieve our goal. So let's look at another example. This time I really want you to consider each stage individually and just think about the inputs and outputs. We're going to do a tweak on our original question of user mentions. And this time we're going to look at who has mentioned the most unique users. So in the same way that we looked at unique hashtags just a minute ago, now we're going to look at modifying this pipeline so that we are only counting mentions of users not already accounted for in our grouping. So here's the code for this. We have our same unwind stage as before, but the group stage is different, and you'll notice that there's another unwind stage here and another group stage here. In the first group stage, what we're doing is aggregating still on the user's screen name, but rather than simply summing up all of the documents that this group stage received in order to calculate all the user mentions, because of course unwind is going to generate one document for every user mention, instead what we're going to do here is use the add to set operator that we looked at just a couple of minutes ago. Now, what we're paying attention to here is the screen name for the user that was actually mentioned in the tweet. So we're accumulating an array here in this group stage of a unique set of users mentioned in tweets produced by this user, or by each user. Okay, but that doesn't get us what we want, because again, remember our question is, who has mentioned the most unique users? Okay, so to this point, all we have is a list of unique users. We haven't counted them yet. Now, in order to do that, what we're going to need to do is think about what's the output from this group stage. Well, the output is going to be exactly what we defined here as the structure of documents coming out of this. All documents will have an underscore ID field, which will be the username that forms the basis for the grouping that that document represents. And there will be this mset field, our mentions set. Okay, so this stage here will receive documents with an underscore ID field and an mset field. So what that means is that we can use unwind again here and produce one document for every item in this array. And again, remember, this is going to be an array of unique elements because we use the add to set operator to produce it. So unwind then will generate one document for every item found in the mset field for each document in its input. So this stage then will unwind this array of unique user mentions and pass those along to this second group stage. And it's this group stage where we end up calculating the count that we want. So instead of just counting all user mentions as we did before here, instead what we're going to do is now count those unique mentions that get passed along to us here after unwinding the mset array. Okay, so the documents then that we pass along from this second group stage to sort are going to contain an ID. This is just a copying over essentially of the ID that we got as input to this stage, which is going to be the ID that was produced here at this stage. And then we're simply counting. How many documents did I receive that have that ID? Or how many unique user mentions did I receive for this specific user? Okay, then we're simply going to sort based on the count field in descending order, as we've been doing through most of our examples. And finally, here I'm going to limit it to 10 so we can actually see what the counts are for unique user mentions for the top 10 tweeters. Okay, so let's run this. Okay, so we can see the names of the users and their respective number of unique user mentions throughout this collection.